Now welcome back to our social studies lesson. This is the third lesson whereby we shall be looking at the factors influencing population distribution in Eastern Africa. And before we start our lesson, it's very much important that we remind ourselves what we discussed in the last lesson. Remember, in the last lesson we are looking at the population distribution in Eastern Africa, and whereby we define some terms related to population. One of the terms that we define, remember, is the word population. We also define the word population distribution. We also define the word population density. We also look at the word density census. We also look at the word density populated. We also look at the word sparsely populated. So let's mind ourselves about the meanings of these terms. Population, we say this is the total number of people in a given area. The total number of people in a given area. For example, we say that the total population of Kenya, according to the census of 2019, was 47.5 million people. That is population, as a meaning of the word population. Then we also have the word population distribution. This is how people are spread in a given area over a given time. How people are spread over a given area at a given time. That is population distribution. Then we have population density. And we say that population density, this is the total number of people living in a square kilometer. Get the difference between population and population density. Here we have said this is the total number of people in a given area. And here, this is the number of people, the total number of people living in a square kilometer. So here we have people living, total number of people living in a square kilometer. Hereby we are not giving a specific area. Then we have the word census, and this is the official counting of people in a given area. And we know that census in Kenya is usually conducted after every 10 years. The census in Kenya, that's the official counting of people, is usually conducted after every 10 years. The last one in Kenya was conducted in 2019. That means the next one will be 2029. And the major reason as why the government conducts census is to plan for its citizens. That's the major reason, to plan. If about knowing the total number of people in the country so that you can know the number of females and the males in the country, no. The major reason why the government conducts census is to plan for its citizens. Then also have the word densely populated. Densely populated means these are the areas with very many people. These are the areas with very, very many people. Sparsely populated is the area which have few people. These are the areas which have few people. When it comes back to Eastern Africa, we say that Ethiopia is the most populated country in Eastern Africa. Ethiopia is the most populated country in Eastern Africa, with around 114.5 million people. With around 114.5 million people, whereby Djibouti is the least populated country in Eastern Africa with around 1 million people. Ethiopia will say that this is the most populated country in Eastern Africa with around 114.5 million people, whereby Djibouti is the least populated country with the people who have a population of around 1 million. We also looked at the region in Eastern, how population is distributed, the regions, how is population distributed in various regions of Eastern Africa, whereby we said some areas are what we call high population population density, whereby others have medium, population, density. And lastly, we have areas where we have low population, density. So the areas with high population density, we say that these areas are above 200, persons per square kilometer. The high population density regions in Eastern Africa, these are the areas which we say they have above 200 persons per square kilometer. Then we have the medium population density areas. And these are the areas which have people between 50 to 200 persons per square kilometer. The medium population density areas or regions, these areas are between 50 to 200 persons per square kilometer. Then we have areas of low population density, and these ones have earlier people below 50. They are below 50 persons per square kilometer. Those are the regions that we talked about the last year, the previous lessons, how the population is distributed in Eastern Africa. One will say high population density, people above 200 persons per square kilometer. Medium population density, this is between 50 to 200 persons per square kilometer. Then we have low population density, this is the areas which are, or regions which are below 50 persons per square kilometer. Now let's go back to the lesson of the day, whereby we are looking at the factors influencing population density in Eastern Africa. Here we have more than 10 factors which influence population distribution in Eastern Africa. How comes that some areas have very many people and some others have very few people, others have medium population? Those are what we are going to discuss. And to guide us in this lesson, let's look at the types of settlements in Eastern Africa. We have one by the name of linear. Linear settlement. This whereby people live in a making a pattern like a line. This way. From the word line, linear, from the word line, whereby the settlements are distributed as if they are making, they are forming a line. Here, this line here, which we can say can be maybe a major form of transport like railway, can be a road, a major road. It can also be a river, source of water, river. Then we also have another one called scattered. Here the population, the settlements are spread everywhere. There's no single pattern that's being what? They are scattered everywhere. They are spread everywhere. That is scattered settlement. Then we have another one by the name of nucleated. This whereby the population is spread at a given point. That is what? That is nucleated. There are some settlements around here, some buildings here, some settlements here. That is what we are saying if we talk about nucleated. Now let's go to the factors influencing population. I've seen there are very many. There are more than 10. And the first factor is climate. Point number one is climate. And to make us much better, we are dividing climate in two areas. One of them is rainfall and the other one is temperature. And for your information, this is the major factor influencing population distribution in Eastern Africa. This is the major factor. Forget about the other. When they ask in exam, which one of the following is the major factor influencing, or the main factor influencing population distribution in Eastern Africa? The answer is climate. So how does the climate under rainfall influence population distribution? Now you find that some areas which receive a lot of rainfall have attract high population, and therefore they have high population density. Here we are being given such a region, there are such a regions as the islands of Kenya, like the central region and the Kisii Island. Those are the areas that we see what? That's the area that we see rainfall in Kenya. When you go to Ethiopia, we have the Ethiopian islands. When you go to Ethiopia, we have the Ethiopian islands. When you cross over to our neighbors, Uganda, we have the Buganda region, and also the western islands of Uganda. When you cross over to Rwanda and Burundi, those are the areas that receive what? Those are the areas that receive receive low amount of rain for Rwanda and Burundi, and also some parts of northern Kenya and northern part of Sudan, they receive low amount of rainfall. Let me show you those areas. Let me show you those areas. Now, say we have.